Hello, and welcome back to the N-Squared World Domination Society. Today we are going to build a high-end gaming and video editing PC for about $1,000. All of the parts I use are described in detail and linked in the description, and I would highly recommend all of them. So first things first, you need to prepare your case. Just take all of the tape and wrapping off, except I would recommend not removing the case on the glass if your case has glass, just to keep it clean and undamaged. Next, remove the left side of your case. My case has two hand screws. If you have a different case, the side might just come off with pressure or a handle. In my old computer, the side just came off with pressure. Go ahead and set the lid aside because you won't need it until the end of the build. If you have the same case as me, there will be a cardboard box in one of the hard drive bays. Do not throw this away. It has some cables and zip ties inside that you will need. While you're at it, go ahead and take off the right panel on your computer. This is for cable wiring and access to the backplate of the processor. You'll need it off eventually. This is the backplate that came with my motherboard. All motherboards have their own unique backplate, so if you have a different motherboard than me, yours will look completely different. However, no matter what it looks like, it will still fit in the small rectangular slot on the back of your case. Next, install the motherboard. Normally you would have to screw in standoff screws, however this motherboard has screws built in, which is a feature I really like. It makes the process much simpler because all I have to do now is line up the standoff screws to the holes in the case and screw them in with the screws that came with the motherboard. Next, install the processor. In my motherboard, you release the two pins and then open the protective lid. Your motherboard might have one pin or it might have none. If there is a square of pins on the motherboard where the processor goes, do not touch these pins. The oils on your skin will ruin them, rendering your motherboard useless. Then install the processor. If there are pins on the processor, do not touch them for the same reason as before. There will be a triangular mark somewhere around where the processor goes that needs to line up with the triangular mark on the processor, or else you will start a fire when you boot your computer. Finally, if your motherboard has pins, put them back in place. Now for the cooling unit. My computer will use a water cooling unit with fans and a filter. Screw the two fans into place on the filter. There should be an arrow showing which way the air flows on your fan. Then screw the filter onto the top of your case using the holes already in the case. Make sure the water hoses are the right way around and aren't in an awkward position. You do not want those bursting because they will get everything wet and ruined, and I mean everything. Then add screws on the backplate of the processor. This motherboard has another great feature where there is a backplate pre-installed. If you have a different motherboard, just use the hole on the right of your case to put the one that came with your processor in place. Then, remove the covering from the bottom of your cooling unit. Do not do this before you are about to put the cooling unit in the processor. It is there so the thermal paste won't smear and damage or stain anything. If there's no thermal paste already on your cooling unit, then put a small amount on the center of your processor between it and the cooler. Finally, while holding all that in place, screw in the cage-like thing that came with your cooling unit over the whole thing. Make sure it is extra tight because if the processor and cooling unit aren't touching, it could start a fire or your computer will overheat instantly after turning on. Literally instantly. I've seen it before. Next, install the power supply. In my case, it goes in the bottom, which is good because the fan blows right out of the bottom of the computer into its own little air filter. What you are seeing now is the cameraman noticing the power supply was installed upside down. If he hadn't noticed that, the fan would have been blowing hot air right onto the Wi-Fi card and two graphics cards, which I imagine wouldn't do me any favors. So thank you, cameraman, for your contributions to the N-squared World Domination Society. After you make sure it is installed correctly, screw the power supply to the case. While you're working over there, I recommend removing the backmost hard drive bay temporarily, if you have the same case as me. It has two screws at the bottom. You can put it back later, it will just make wiring cables much easier because of the extra space. Now install your graphics cards and other random cards. I have two graphics cards and an internet card for my old PC, as I mentioned before. Now, what I've just done here is very unsafe. The top graphics card isn't going to get any airflow, therefore it won't cool down. Also, they're very hard to remove. Time for the RAM. Now, when installing RAM, cameraman? Back already? And with the motherboard manual? Yes, now, that is because I have cut out about 7 minutes of the two of us trying to figure out how to install the RAM. Sometimes it's the most simple of things. This motherboard is very different in that you only have to push down one lever at the end of the RAM slot, unlike both in all other motherboards I've seen. Now, to install non-SSD hard drives in this case, just remove one of the slots on the bottom and snap the hard drive into place. I cut here because I installed the hard drive backwards and didn't realize it until later in the video. Normally, it should slide in with ease. I will show you the correct orientation of the hard drive at 7:38 in the video in case you want to skip ahead. Now, for installing SSD hard drives, there are special compartments on the right side of the case. Just pop one of the trays off with a little bit of pressure and slide the SSD in. Then, snap it back in place. This hard drive is installed correctly with the SSD art facing inward as shown. They are in this odd location to make room for extra cooling fans or water cooling systems for graphics cards and such. Finally, to install an optical drive in this case, take off the front two panels using a small amount of pressure. Then, also using pressure, punch out as many slots in the topmost lid as you have optical drives. Then slide the optical drive in the front of the case and it should snap into place. Finally, just put the covers back on the front of the case. Cables can only be installed in one place in one way, so check your manuals if you need help. To correctly install a non-SSD hard drive, first plug its cables in, then snap it into the slider with the cables going into the back of the case, not the front. The hard drive will now fit correctly. Once all the cables coming from the power supply have been routed to the back via the rubber holes, that's what they're there for, by the way, in case you didn't know, you can go ahead and screw that hard drive bay back into place. Now, if you bought the same cooling unit as me, you probably noticed the two weird cables coming out of the liquid cooler over the processor labeled fan power in the manual. So did I. We figured out you can remove the tip of the wires coming out of the processor to reveal pins that let you plug any fan into the processor to free up space on the motherboard. Very helpful after you figure it out because I believe the motherboard itself can only support 4 to 5 fans, so the extra 4 cables will really go a long way over the years. Now, something I seriously recommend with a glass-sided case is a computer LED light strip kit. I'll link the one I'm using in the description along with the other parts. It is designed for computers, so it is remote controlled and has 16 colors with 5 modes counting a solid color. It can be brightened, dimmed, or turned off entirely. It also uses power from the computer, so you'll never have to break open your PC to replace batteries. I'll show it off at the end, but I seriously recommend them. Finally, and I mean it this time, put all of the lids back onto the case because you have just built yourself your very own high-end video editing and gaming PC. Now, this particular PC will last me at least 10 to 15 years easily before I even consider getting a new one. The only thing I have gotten to tax this computer is running the 10,000% speed time lapses in Premiere Pro. They brought 8 gigs of RAM to 75% usage and the CPU to about 40%. However, this motherboard can support 128 gigs of RAM, so I will be upgrading in the near future. Also, the power button on the front doesn't work. I probably got a defective case, so I will use the power button on the motherboard, but if you've had the same problem, please tell me how you fixed it in the comments. However, even if all of the cases of this type had a broken power button, I would still highly recommend them. Now, a computer like this deserves a name, so after a lot of thought, I would like to introduce you all to Sim. She is named after Saria, the Ocarina of Time character, whose name I recently learned my family had been pronouncing wrong for the better part of 10 years. I recommend you get familiar with her because Sarah will be to the N-squared World Domination Society as Jarvis is to Iron Man, only a bit more feminine. Alright, that's it today. Sorry for the lack of videos, however there is a reason I built a new computer today, and it's not only because I needed an upgrade. Nevertheless, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, consider liking, favoriting, and sharing it. Subscribe so you can catch all the amazing robotics, electronics, and 3D printing projects I have planned. Also comment on what you liked and what you didn't so I can make future videos even better. Thanks for watching.